EU approves controversial copyright directive, including internet link tax and upload filter.
Og det hedenskap, hedenskap holdt ut.
Ja, velkommen til en liten ekstra sending fra ETV-bloggen. Jeg vil bare informere om at nå klokka 18, og det er ikke lenge til, det er bare et snøtt kvarter til, så er det direkte sending på Kaffebloggen sin hovedkanal. Da må du søke etter Kaffebloggen på YouTube hvis du ikke allerede er abonnent. Og så bør du abonnere, og så bør du trykke på denne varslingsbjellen, så du får varsler om både premierer og direkte sendinger på Kaffebloggens hovedkanal. Altså det blir, som sagt, direkte sending der når klokka er 18. Og det er bare et lite kvarter til, eller et snøyt kvarter til. Ja, i det kvarteret der så tenkte jeg at vi kunne bruke tiden til å se bittelitt på dette her med skjebnen til YouTube, hva som skal skje. Uff, det ser ille ut dette her. Ta så se på denne, men husk å se direkte sendingen fra Kaffebloggen klokka 18.00.
3, 2, 1. 2019 will be the worst year in YouTube history. You want to know why? Well, stay tuned and watch this video because we're going straight into that. Well, hey, how's it going, guys? Welcome back to another new, fresh episode of the Tech Realm. And if you're new here, then you probably have no idea who I am. That's perfectly fine because you don't need to. But if you aren't new here, I'd like to quickly say thanks so much for the support in clicking this video. And you can go so much further with that support if you were to simply click that bell option next to the subscribe option. And that would make sure that you would see each and every single one of my videos every single time that I posted. But enough about that. Let's get straight into the topic of today's video. Why 2019 will be the absolute worst year for YouTube. Now, some of us are YouTube content creators, and some of us are simply passive viewers that watch every single video of some random person you subscribe to. Or maybe you just scroll through the recommended section and click on something that's interesting every single time. Either way, there's a 100% chance that the person watching this video is using YouTube. Now, if you were to take a moment to think to yourself, how much do I like YouTube? Do I appreciate YouTube? Do I support YouTube? Or do I simply use it because it provides an outlet for me to watch simple videos? Originally, YouTube sparked an entire new era which would inevitably replace TV. And nowadays, it's so mainstream that people don't even think twice when using it. It's almost as mainstream as simply saying, Google it, because everyone uses Google and no other search engine.
Unless you actually use Bing or Yahoo. In which case, I'm so sorry for you.
And since YouTube is so mainstream, most people aren't able to see the things that negatively affect it. Today, we're going to be going into certain events that will take place in 2019, which will cause it to be the worst year for YouTube.
Number one.
T-Series will officially pass PewDiePie in the year 2019. It's 100% inevitable and there's no arguing against it. And the funny thing is, this whole issue between PewDiePie versus T-Series, but I'm 100% sure that once T-Series actually passes PewDiePie, it'll only be like a couple weeks before everyone even forgets what T-Series is again. And literally no one will even care. But there's far greater significance to this than just that. T-Series, which is a multi-million dollar company taking the number one spot on YouTube, will completely go against what YouTube has always stood for, a place where you can broadcast yourself. After all, I'm pretty sure that's what the U is for in the YouTube, so a company taking the number one spot will just be simple supply and demand. However, it will kind of take away the U portion of YouTube as well. As we've seen YouTube progress through time, we can clearly indicate that it is currently replacing TV and so many other media outlets that used to be dominant before, which means a lot of companies and other things are moving on to YouTube, corporatizing it in so many different ways. And this pushes out the original content creators that were the foundation of the website before. So by the end of 2019, the most subscribed YouTube channel will be T-Series, and the top 10 most subscribed channels in history will also most likely be companies. Only about one or two of them will be individual people.
Which is kinda sad.
Number two.
The YouTube copyright system. For years now, you've probably seen, on and off, people complaining about being falsely accused of copyright on YouTube. From false claims of copyright to complete channel takedowns for literally no reason, the copyright system on YouTube has always been just a little bit flawed. And as of the beginning of this year in general, it seems to have taken a turn for the worse. Countless amounts of people have had their videos completely taken down, along with being falsely copyright flagged. The system works in a way that any company or individual could flag a video for using copyrighted material, regardless if that video actually did. YouTube automatically sides with the accuser. And what happens when a YouTube video gets flagged through copyright? Is that individual who flagged it will get all of the money and earnings from it. And sometimes this could result in even a video being taken down. And if multiple videos are taken down, this could result in the entire channel being removed. Now, as we could see, this is a tiny bit problematic. I myself have gotten multiple false claims from companies such as UMG over things that were completely fair use. I'm generally not the type of person to go on Twitter and rant about things like that, so you won't really hear me complaining about it, but sometimes it just goes a little bit too far. So if something isn't done about the copyright system soon, then a lot of people will be ending up leaving YouTube and most likely not being able to generate enough money to continue making videos. So hopefully something will be done about this, or at the very least, hopefully not that many people will leave YouTube. But hey, I guess that's how YouTube works.
Number 3.
The YouTube Rewind 2019. At this point, can we just delete YouTube Rewind? I think pretty much everyone would agree that it doesn't even need to exist anymore. Unless we're talking about PewDiePie's Rewind, which was completely epic. Yeah! Quite frankly, I think YouTube Spotlight should just become PewDiePie. It's basically the only spotlight on the website anyways. But yeah, 2019 YouTube Rewind. I am going to make an entirely separate video about this in the coming future, so stay tuned for that. However, at the current rate of progression, I'm pretty sure we can all agree that most likely, it won't be that good. And if anything, will be the new worst. But I'm going to give YouTube the benefit of the doubt and say there's a good chance that it might be good. But don't quote me on that.
Number 4.
And finally, the absolute worst thing which will make 2019 the worst year on YouTube is... Rice cum. Nah, I'm just kidding. It's Article 13. If you don't know what Article 13 is, it's basically a legislation that will take place in the European countries, which will basically ban memes and will restrict YouTube to the point where you probably won't even be able to watch it that much. And it's even a bigger deal than net neutrality. This will be basically a huge censorship thing for YouTube. And if the whole thing is approved, then YouTube itself will basically be ruined. So in my opinion, it's a good thing to stand against it as well. It is a real shame that not many people are talking about this, because this will be a huge issue that will affect everyone if it goes through. And if it does, which unfortunately it most likely will, it will completely ruin the website in a lot of countries in 2019. So there you have it. All the reasons why 2019 will be the absolute worst, most atrocious, terrible, unepic year of YouTube history. I wish I was making this stuff up, but unfortunately, I'm not. I could actually make an hour-long documentary talking about other things, but I think these are the most important by far. And if you do agree with me, then I'd recommend you go down around 2 inches from this screen and turn that little thumb button, which is usually gray, and make it blue. And if you do this, you will actually get 10 years of good luck. Now, I usually don't do this, but I do want to give back to all the viewers that watch this far into the video. I will be subscribing to a couple people in the comments section who are accurately able to count how many times I said the word YouTube in this video. Just shout the number in the comment section right now if you're watching this. And even if you're not exactly correct, I'll still slip in a subscribe for you because I'm just feeling generous today. And thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys and you'll see me in the next video. Goodbye.
Self-destruct sequence activated.
Nok så skremmende video. Ja, nå klokka snart 6, så nå må dere skifte til Kaffebloggen sin hovedkanal, for der begynner det nå direkte sending om ganske, ganske få minutter. Så velkommen på Kaffebloggens hovedkanal til direkte sending. Det skal bli kjekt å se dere der. Imagine there's no heaven.